Welcome to Aloha Commentary. I'm Guy, the Hawaii Blues fan, host of the BlueNote Fan Report.
Well, I have something planned today. I'm not sure how it's going to go. It's really windy out here. As you can see, Chinaman hat, and that's actually the real Chinaman's hat, not the one I showed last time. I got confused. Today, we're continuing on with our 10 most gut-wrenching moments in blues history. I'll show the moments that we've gone over here, and once I get to the island, we'll continue on. Aloha! Sitting at the bottom of Chinaman's hat after part one of our 3 or 4 part adventure. With me today is Brett Freeland. Brett was born in St. Louis and was named after Brett Hull. We're going to go to the top of Chinaman's hat to tell you about the most gut-wrenching moment number 7 and the most gut-wrenching moments number 2 for the guys and number 2 for me. So please join us on our journey to the top.
been an adventure to get to the top of the world. Somewhat. I mean, there's higher places, but for a 52-year-old man making it up here is pretty special in this weather. It's beautiful here. It's rough down there.
Well, aloha. I gotta hold my mic like this. I'm up here at the very top of Chinaman's Hat with Brett Freeland. The number 7 most gut-wrenching moment for both the Bluenotes podcast and the Bluenote Fan Report, me, is the 1999 President's Cup team. This is a team that was loaded with talent. They scored 114 points, had 51 wins, and it just looked like they were going to go all the way. It was our cup. Do you agree, Brett? Yeah, thanks, Brett. That's a real good comment you made there. We knew that this was going to make it, and then it came up against the Sharks, and the Sharks had a hell of a team, right, Brett? You're right, Brett. They did have a really, really good team, but the Blues should have won, and this was another one of those moments when Blues fans just felt like nothing was going to go right for them. Now we get to the number 2 most gut-wrenching moment. And for me, I'll do mine first. My number 2 most gut-wrenching moment is the picture. The 1970 Stanley Cup Finals Game 4, Bobby Orr flying across the goal after he scores. Noel Picard tripped him, supposedly, and in celebration, he goes flying across the ice. A picture's taken, and we have to deal with that picture now everywhere. It is the number 1 moment in Stanley Playoff Cup history. It's the number 1 overtime moment. If it's a moment, it's number 1. Nothing beats it in history. Do you agree with me, Brett? Yeah, I thought so. Man, you're just talking a lot today, buddy. So that's my number 2 moment, and I remember it. I see the picture all the time. Now, the guy's number 2 moment was my number 4 moment, and that is the Mike Keenan era. In 95-96, Mike Keenan leaves the Rangers and comes to the Blues as head coach and general manager. Everybody in Bluesland was absolutely excited. We thought Iron Mike was going to get us that ring. Don't you agree, Brett? He's right. He thought Iron Mike was going to get us it. I thought we were going to get it, but it didn't happen. I reached out to someone I know in the Blues organization who was there at that time, and they told me 2 things about Iron Mike. 1, he was a great coach. He was a fair GM, but as a GM and coach, he was an abomination. And he also told me a story. He was with Iron Mike, or he was with Dan Kelly in Philadelphia. They go down in the forum to meet Iron Mike to get the goalie, the starting goalie. He asked Iron Mike who the starting goalie is going to be, and Iron Mike says, I haven't made up my mind yet. In true Dan Kelly fashion, Dan Kelly says, F you, Keaton. I know who's the starting pitcher for Game 4 of the World Series. You damn well know who the starting goalie is for Game 4 of the NHL season. And then walked away. My friend said, I just looked at Mike and said, I guess I'm not getting my starting goalie, and walked away. Mike was just not good with people, and that's how he was. Well, guys, I got one more part of this adventure to share with you, and I'll see you at the bottom. Aloha. Aloha. Well, we've done it. We reached the end of our adventure. And just like the Blues fans in 1970, 1999, and the Mike Keenan era, we are completely exhausted. So, this is Guy and Brett saying aloha and mahalo. Tom and Wags, can't wait to hear what you got to say about all this. Aloha, mahalo, and we'll see you on the next Aloha Commentary and the Bluenote Fan Report. Aloha.
NFL season, and then walked away. Yeah, what's going on, man? Does he